Good morning, my dear students. Welcome you all to this session. Today's class, we are going to start with the new concept, what is an identity? Okay. So in this concept, you should know what is meant by equation. Okay. First, you should know what is an equation. Then we'll deal with the identity. Okay. So you can take page number 148 in your NCERT textbook. Okay. So listen. First, whatever it is given in the textbook, I'll teach you. Okay. So it will be more understandable. Okay. So first, what it is given? A plus 1 into A plus 2. They have multiplied this. So A into A square plus A into 2A plus 1 into A 1A plus 1 into 2. Now A square 2A plus 1A plus 3A plus 2. So what is the value of A plus 1 into A plus 2? A square plus 3A plus 2. So this is what the it is an equality. Why it is said as equality means this LHS is equal to RHS by using the equation. But we have to check whether LHS is equal to RHS. How you will check means you will substitute a few values to the variable and we have to check whether LHS is equal to RHS. So first we have to take A value as 10. I am going to take A value as 10. So what is the LHS question? LHS, what is the left hand side? A plus 1 into A plus 2. Correct? What is the A value? 10. 10 plus 1 into 10 plus 2. Yes? 10 plus 1, 11. 10 plus 2, 12. 11 12s are 132. So LHS value is 132. Next, RHS value. What is the right hand side? A square plus 3A plus 2. A square is what? What is the A value, children? 10. 10 square plus 3 into 10 plus 2. 10 square 100 plus 3 tens are 30 plus 2. 100 plus 30, 130 plus 2, 132. See, both LHS and RHS are equal. So, see, if the variable is given as 10, LHS and RHS are equal. If the variable is given as A is equal to minus 5, LHS value what you are getting? 12. RHS value what you are getting? That also 12. So, for any variable value, LHS and RHS will be equal for this equation. So, that equation is called as identity. What? Identity. Okay. So, then bolded letters they are given. See, such an equality true for every value of a variable in it is called identity, which means for any values of A, not only 10, not only minus 5, 100, 200, any values of A, this LHS and RHS will be equal, then this equality and equation, okay, equality, because it has equal to sign, so this is equation, so this equation or this equality is called as identity. But equation means it will be true only for particular value of a variable. Okay. Sometimes some equation will be there. See, in that question itself they have given A square plus 3A plus 2. 2 is equal to 132. So actually this is one equation. This is one identity. Why it is identity means for every values of A this equation will satisfy. But for this, this is an equation. Why? Because for A is equal to 10, 10 square plus 3 into 10 plus 12, 10 square 100 plus 30 plus 2, 132. Only for A is equal to 10, this will be satisfied. This is LHS, this is RHS. Both are equal. Only for A is equal to 10, it will be satisfied. So this is called as equation. So for every values of A it satisfies, that is identity. That equality is called as identity. So if it satisfies only for one particular value of variable, one particular value of variable, it is called as equation. Okay, did you understand this? And we have certain standard equations where we will be using for many times, that we are going to discuss today. Okay. standard identities I'm going to teach you. So first standard identity is a plus b the whole square. What is the standard identity? A plus b the whole square. Now I'm going to derive this identity. A plus b the whole square means what is the meaning? A plus b into a plus b. Correct? X square means x into x. Up a plus b the whole square means a plus b into a plus b. Now shall we multiply a into a and a into b? A into a is a square plus a into b is a b. Next b into a plus b a plus b into b plus b square. Next, a square plus ab plus ab is plus 2ab or ba plus b square. So, what is the a plus b the whole square value? A plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. See, this is your standard identity. So, whenever if anyone asks you a plus b the whole square means a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so this is what your standard identity. Next standard identity is a minus b the whole square. Here a plus b, here a minus b. That is the difference. So a minus b into a minus b. Okay, a minus b into a minus b. So multiplying this, a is multiplied with a and b. A into a square. A into minus b minus a b. Minus b into a minus a b. Minus b into minus b plus b square. Now, a square minus ab minus ab minus 2ab plus b square. So, what is the answer from a minus b the whole square, children? A square minus 2ab plus b square. So, what is a plus b the whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b the whole square? A square minus 2ab plus b square. That is the only difference. Plus 2ab minus 2ab. Okay, next. A plus b into a minus b. This is the next identity. So what you will do? A plus b into a minus b. I am just multiplying a square a into minus b minus a b. B into a plus b a. B into minus b minus b square. Plus a b minus a b 0. A square plus 0 minus b square. So what is answer? A square minus b square. So a plus b into a minus b is what? A square minus b square. So this is your third identity. You see, in that box itself they have given that you should learn it. Okay, see, we can't directly add and see for everything. So what you're doing is you should keep it in your mind, these three identities. Next, your fourth identity. Now x plus a into x plus b. X plus a into x plus b. X into x, x square. X into b, xb. Plus a into x, ax. Plus a into b, ab. So this is what this. Okay, I have multiplied. Now what I'm doing is, in this two, x is common, right? So what you're doing, x square plus b plus a into x. I'm taking x outside from these two terms. B plus a into x plus ab. So what is the answer? X square plus b plus a is nothing but a plus b. Correct? Into x plus ab. So what is the answer for x plus a into x plus b, children? X square plus a plus b into x plus ab. So this is what your fourth identity. So how many identities are there? Four identities are there. A plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b the whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Then a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. Next, x plus a into x plus b is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Understood? Next is your example number 11. Okay, using the identity number 1, first identity, we are supposed to find 2x plus 3 the whole square. Usually, if this question is given and if the identity is not there, what you will do? You will write like 2x plus 3y into 2x plus 3y, and you will multiply like this, correct? And you will find the answer. But here we have an identity. What is the identity? Plus is there in between. So what is identity you will use? A plus B the whole square identity you will use because we have plus in between. So A plus B the whole square identity you will be using here. So what is the answer? A square plus 2AB plus B square. So what is the A here? 2x, B 3y, correct? So instead of A you can write 2x the whole square plus 2 into A value 2x, B value 3y plus B square 3y square, correct? Just substituting A and B value, that's all. 2x the whole square means 2 2s are 4, x into x, x square. 2x the whole square means what? 2 2s are, everything you should multiply 2 times, that's all. 2 2s are 4, x are x square. Now, 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, x into y, xy. Plus, 3 3s are 9, y into y, y square. So, this is what the value you are getting using the identity. Okay, next is your second problem. 103 the whole square. 103 the whole square, which means 103 the whole square. 103 how you will write, children? 100 plus 3, correct? The whole square. 103 how you will write? 100 plus 3 the whole square. So plus is given. So what identity you will use here? A plus B the whole square. So here A plus B the whole square is equal to A square plus 2ab plus b square. So what is the a value here? 100. B value is 3. So 100 the whole square plus 2 into 100 into 3 plus 3 in 3 the whole square. So 100 square is how much? 10,000. 100 square is 10,000. Next 2 into 100, 200. 200 into 3, 600. Plus 3 3s are 9. Now 10,000 plus 600, 10,600. 10,600 plus 9, 10,609. So answer is 10,609. So 103 the whole square is 10,609. Understood? Just plus is given. So I am using A plus B the whole square identity. Understood? Next is your example number 12. Use the identity to find 4p minus 3q the whole square. See here, minus is given. So what identity you will use? A minus b the whole square. Yes, what is identity? A square minus 2ab plus b square. So what is the a value here, children? 4p, b value is 3q because here minus is there, so here also minus is there. So a value is 4p, b value is 3q. So what is the a here? A square means 4p the whole square minus 2 into a is 4p, b is 3q plus b square means 3q the whole square. Okay, so 4p the whole square means 4 4s are 16, p into p, p square. Minus 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24, p into q, pq. Plus 3 3s are 9, q into q, q square. So this is my answer. Okay, just multiplying it. 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24, p into q, pq. This as usual multiplication, this is what the answer. Okay, now 4.9 the whole square. How you will write this 4.9 as? Like second identity, how you will write it? Subtraction should come in between. Okay. So 5.0 minus 0.1. Okay. So if you subtract 5.0 and 0.1, if you subtract it, what you will get? 4. Here 10. 10 minus 1, 9. So you will get 4.9. So instead of 4.9, you can write 5.0 minus 0.1 the whole square. So A minus B the whole square means A square minus 2ab plus b square. What is A? 5.0. B 0.1. 5.0 the whole square minus 2 into 5.0 into 0.1 plus 0.1 the whole square. See, 5.0 is nothing but 5 square. Correct? Minus 2 into 5.0 has become 5 into 0.1. ओके 5.05 दिस 5.05 प्लस 0.1 दी होल स्क्वायर 5 स्क्वायर 25 माइनस 5 टू जार 10 10 इंटू 0.1 1 प्लस 0.1 द होल स्क्वायर सो व्हाट यू विल राइट 0.1 इंटू 0.1 वन सा 1 0.01 ओके सो 0.1 द होल स्क्वायर आंसर इज व्हाट 0.01 सो नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू वी आर सपोज टू सब्ट्रैक्ट और ऐड बेस्ड अपॉन दैट ओके सो हियर 0.01 नाउ 24 माइनस 1 इज व्हाट 24 माइनस 1 25 माइनस 1 इज 24 प्लस 0.01 सी 25 माइनस 1 इज 24 24 प्लस 0.01 इज 24.01 ओके आंसर इज 24.01 सी 5 फाइव्स आर 25 5 टूस आर 10 10 इंटू 0.1 ओके 10 इंटू 0.1 इज व्हाट 1 ओके प्लस 0.01 सो 25 माइनस 1 इज 24 24 प्लस 0.01 इज 24.01 ओके अंडरस्टैंड नेक्स्ट यूज द आइडेंटिटी नंबर 3 फाइंड दिस वैल्यू सी आइडेंटिटी नंबर 3 इज व्हाट a प्लस b इंटू a माइनस b सी हियर 3 बाय 2 m 3 बाय 2 m सो दिस इज a 2 बाय 3 n 2 बाय 3 n b So, A plus B, A minus B. Correct? See, same A value is given, B value is given. So, A plus B, A minus B is equal to A square minus B square. What is A here? 3 by 2 M the whole square minus 2 by 3 the N the whole square because A is 3 by 2 M, B is 2 by 3 N. So, 3 by 2 the whole square means 3 square 9 divided by 2 square 4. 3 3s are 9, 2 2s are 4, m into m, m square minus 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9, n into n, n square. So this is my final answer. So next, 983 square minus 17 square. So this looks like a square minus b square, correct? A square, B square. So, what is the formula? A plus B. This inverse formula. This is given. You should find this. A plus B into A minus B. So, what is A here? 983 plus 17. B is 17. Into 983 minus 17. 983 plus 17 means how much? 10, 1, 10, 1000. 1000. Okay. 983 plus 17 is 1000. Next, 983 minus 17 is how much? 6 is a 7. 1, 6, 6, 9, 966. So now, if I subtract these two, I'm getting 966. If I add these two, I'm getting 1000. So 1000 into 966 is 966000. 966000. Okay? Next is your third subdivision, 194 into 206. So now we have to split this based upon identity number 3. Okay. So this is 194 can be split as 200 minus 6, correct? Into 206 can be split as 200 plus 6, correct? 194 can be split as 200 minus 6. 206 can be split as 200 plus 6. So, this is A minus B, A plus B. A minus B, A plus B. Because A are same, B are same. So, what is the answer? A square minus B square. What is A? 200 square minus 6 square. 200 square is 2 2s are 4, 0 0 0 0. Minus 36 square, 36. So 4000 minus 36 is 39991. 4 6 9 9 3. Answer is 39964. Did you understand? I have to split it based upon the identity number 3. Understood? This is your example number 14. Use the identity x plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus ab to find the following. Okay, now we have to separate this. Okay, see, this 501 can be written as 500 plus 1 into 500 plus 2. Correct? 501 can be written as 500 plus 1. 502 can be written as 500 plus 2. So, using this property, x plus a into x plus b. Here, listen, x alone should be same. A, b should be different. So, only then you will use this property. In the previous problem, a and a are same, b and b are same. So, you should use this property. Here, in the next identity, you should use this one, because x should be same. X is 500, a, b should be different. So, what is the formula? X square into a plus b into x plus a, b. X square means what? 500 square plus a is what? 1, b is what? 2 into x is what? 500 plus a, 1, 2, b. Okay, so 500 square is 5 5s are 25, 0 0 0 0 plus 2 plus 1 3 into 500, because this is bracket operation. 2 plus 1 3 into 500 plus 1 into 2 2. Now 2 5 0 0 0 0 plus 3 5s are 15, 0 0 plus 2. Now I am just going to add all the 3. Okay, 2 5 0 0 0 0 0 0 5 1 2 2 0 5 1 5 2. Answer is 2 5 1 5 0 2. 2 5 1 5 0 2. Just see, children, when x is same and a and b are different, then you should use this property. Okay, identity. Now, second one, 95 into 103. 95 word, how you can write it? 100 or no, okay, 100 minus 5, correct? Yes, 95, how you will write? 100 minus 5. Next, 103, how you will write it? 100 plus 3, okay? So, this is what the, because I want x should be same, right? 95, 100 minus 5. 103, 100 plus 3. So, here x is same. A is minus 5, B is plus 3. Okay, so x square means 100. See, x square, 100 square. Plus A value, minus 5. Next, B value, plus 3 into 100. X plus A value, minus 5. B value, 3. So, 100 square is 4 zeros. Plus minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2 into 100 plus minus 5 into 3 minus 15. Now, 10,000 plus into minus minus 2 into 100, 200 plus into minus minus 15. Now, 10,000 minus 200, 9,800. Minus 15. So now 7, 9, 1, 5, 8, 7, 9. So answer is 9,785. Did you understand? So see, once again, you work out these problems. Only then if you work out more problems, you'll understand it clearly. So in this property, x should be same. That's all. Here a, b. Substituting in the formula, I have found the answer. Understood? I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.